Okay, so I am on my way to cut my hair. I know it's been a while since I have made a video about my hair, and I just feel like it's time for it to go. I cut it off about 7 years ago when I was pregnant and crazy and thinking, oh my gosh, I don't want to look crazy in the delivery room. So I cut it all off, and it's been growing and growing. And now, yeah, I am on my way to hack it all off again. So I'm driving, so I don't want to crash the car, so I'm gonna let you go now. Yes. Bye.
Look at this weather. Look at this weather. I swear, I'm so happy I'm not getting my hair flat ironed or straightened, or I'll be madder than a mofo today, I tell you that. Welcome to sunny Florida. It's around 3 o'clock. That's what happens in the summer. Okay.
So I'm here getting my hair cut by Brina. Say hi, Brianna!
So this is how long my hair is now, and Brianna's gonna shave it all off. She told me not to go anywhere else because stylists have to hack hair off.
Okay, I don't know when I'm gonna come back next. I might be bald headed.
About to cut.
Yay!
First cut is the deepest.
I'm just super dramatic effect.
How much is it, Chip?
Okay. I'll see you after it's all cut off. Bye-bye. I don't know who I'm talking to.
I did it! I cut it all off, and I absolutely love it. First off, let me let you check out the style.
I don't know if you can see in the back because I can't see what you can see. Anyway, I like it. First off, I got my hair done at a salon called Lambs Eat Ivy in Thornton Park. That's in Orlando. And the stylist's name is Brianna Dunning. We've been friends for about 10 years, a little over. I met her while I was working the front desk of another salon. And like most naturals, we don't really go to this salon to get our hair professionally done a lot. So anytime I needed something like updo, she would do my hair. She did my hair for my re-wedding, my vow renewal. Oh, I'm gonna do that thing where it cuts to another photo. So she did my hair for my re-wedding. And now back. So when I wanted to get my hair cut, and I just thought I wanted to cut it all off. I was just overwhelmed and tired of it. It was a change. People always thought I was being silly when I said, I think my hair's boring. It was just boring to me because I've had it so long. So anyway, I think it was last month, I texted Brianna and told her that this is what I wanted. Tapered sides and back, like super short. A bit more on the top, enough to pull some curls on the front and hang on my forehead, and maybe flat iron for some pixie cut action, but short enough for me to be able to jump out of bed, spritz and go, or slick back down Josephine Baker style. I'm surprised you didn't just tell me to get a wig. Anyway, so yesterday, this is my post birthday present to myself. My birthday is September 4th, and I turned the big 39. So I was like, I'm just gonna cut it. I'm tired. I'm gonna cut it. And I had this whole day planned where I was gonna cut it up. I was gonna have the whole day to spend, maybe making a better pre-video. But then I got called in to work at Disney. I'm like, I like making money, so I had to grab everything and throw in the car and go to work. And that's another thing, okay, for my job at Disney, I had to wear a wig. And that wig, with my hair growing, it just hurt. It hurt all the time. I had like indention in my forehead after my shift. So that's another reason why I wanted to cut my hair. So anyway, it was raining cats and dogs when I got there. And I looked like a drowned rat, but still got it cut. So I really, really, really do enjoy it, and I love it. And this is the first time, I'm just rambling, this is the first time that I cut my hair with the intention of keeping it short. Because when I did my big, no more lie cut in 2000, I cut it and figured I'd grow it out long again. And then in 2006, when I was about 6-7 months pregnant. I went crazy and told them to cut it all off. But every time I always thought, you know, I'll just grow it out. But this time I think I might be short for a while. So that's going to be a new experience. Going to get it maintained and, you know, getting it edged up and like, making hair appointments or that. I don't know. Every 2-3 months. I don't know how often I'm supposed to go and get my hair cut again. It's a new experience. What else? People ask me what my husband thought or would think about me cutting my hair, and I mean he's so easygoing. He doesn't care. He says he loves it. He told me, well, you know, get it cut short. That's less money you'll spend on hair products. Little does he know, I might use less products, but that doesn't mean I'm going to buy less, because now I think I'm back in full product junkie mode. Right now I have Kinky Curly Curling Custard. No, I just have the knot today, because I ran out of curling custard a while ago. So I just have the knot today and the Eco Echo Wacko Styler. You know what I'm talking about. And some juices and berries from Oyen? Yeah, Oyen. And not that much, but I'm probably going to do the Diva Curl to see how I like that with my short hair, because I really like the conditioner. And maybe I'll try the curling custard again. And you know what? Product junkie mode in effect again. Let's see. Like I said, I love this cut. If I was not an actor, I think I would have gone a little bit more dramatic with the sides, like shave the sides even closer and leave them more on the top. But because of my chosen profession, I can't look too extreme of any look, because I have to be able to look like a banker. I have to look like a soccer mom who will sell you your orange juice. So I just had to keep it a little neutral. But I think I can. I think I can do a lot of stuff with it. I could slick it all back. I could, you know, wear a hat. That's another thing. I can wear a hat with ease. Just plop it on. I don't have to pull my hair back into a low bun. Riding on airplanes will be more comfortable, because usually with my hair, I would have to pile my hair on top of my head, so I wouldn't get this, because I like to sleep on the airplanes because I don't like to fly, so I just kind of knock myself out. I mean, not with anything illicit or anything, I just will myself to sleep. But my hair, if it's in a ponytail, I can't sleep and I have a crook in my neck and it sucks. But now, you know, I'm good. Washing my hair doesn't take forever. It's not gonna take forever to dry. Oh, I need to get a diffuser. I never had one of those before, but I think this time I'm gonna need a diffuser. I think that might be about it. Gotta make appointments for new headshots. Yay! Because my other headshots, I have long hair. Let's see. I have long hair. Like this. And I'm back. So yeah, I need new headshots, because my agents aren't gonna be really pleased if they send my headshots to a casting director and I have long hair and I come in and I'm like, hey y'all, I cut it, sorry, my bad. And I'm just really excited to go, whenever I go back to work at Disney, to be able to just slap on my wig and not have to braid it and just try to get it on. So here is a picture of me in my my Disney costume. It's this. I'm back. Yeah, so that's about it. Thank you for listening to my rambling, and I love it. And if you want to go back to, you know, to little TWA, go for it, man. It's just, it's hair. It'll grow back. Yay. All right. Bye.